All right, guys, we've got a big important day today. We're going to be starting up the new 2-3 uniform for the first time. This Stoots IO-370 from Continental, and it's going to be a beauty here on a cold October day. We've been working hard for a long time getting this done, so we're pretty excited to finally take this big step of starting it up, seeing how things will go. So come join and let's see how it goes. Is our beautiful 1963 172. Recently we had a pretty big engine issue that meant we were going to upgrade. That's basically where we got with the whole process. Go back and watch the videos if you want to see that, but we're constantly bringing this 1963 172 into the future, and we have the engine that is going to be done now. I've been working with Stoots Aviation. He's also here in Alaska, and we've been diligently working on getting this thing done. I could go through hours and hours of content and show you guys all the little steps in between, but here we are. It's been very busy and we're ready to get going. So cross your fingers. Hopefully everything goes good today. It is a bit chilly. We had kind of the first freeze here in Homer for the year. And so we're gonna be pulling it out of the hangar right when we need to, starting it up, checking for leaks. This is a very serious endeavor because we wanna make sure that all the mechanical stuff that we've done has been very sound. And so I'm not gonna have a camera out there once we start up. I'm gonna be doing some hand signals with Dave if I need to cut the engine off, whatever, looking for leaks, anything like that. So being really, really careful about the whole thing. But exciting to hear her liven up for the first time. A little bit hard to believe, but you know, here we are. We're gonna see how it goes. We've tightened down everything, checked everything, and we're nice and ready. So just waiting for my family to show up because this is gonna be a big deal. And then we're gonna open up the hangar and pull her out and see how she goes.
Two 3 uniform is officially out of the hangar after 8+ months since her last flight. And now we get the camera set up and run through a game plan. It's very important that I'm focused on looking for any leaks or anything out of the ordinary. So I'm not gonna be filmmaking, I'm just gonna be focused on that. So Dave and I briefed that really well before we get started. Then you'll see my friend Wes standing here. He has a fire extinguisher and he's on standby. While we check everything very closely before again and again and again, it's better to be safe than sorry. This is a seriously major upgrade and we want to be quite careful. With all that prep completed, things double and triple checked. It's time to turn avgas into noise. Now, I don't want to be talking during this whole process. Let's let 2-3 uniform do the talking. I'll point out a few things with text and let you know what's going on along the way. But I'd love if you just listen to the purr, even the roar of the engine, and enjoy the sound of power and progress. Here we go. It's time to yell something I haven't yelled in a long, long time.
Thank you.
It's a huge relief to see 2-3 uniform running again after all of what our family has been through this year. Seeing this machine come alive has mended a complicated and unspoken part of our hearts. So with all the excitement, we decided to pull 2-3 uniform out into the sun, with the majestic mountains behind laden with new winter snow, and get some pictures of Dave and I, the family, the kids, etc. Then the whole crew helps push 2-3 uniform and tuck her back into the nest, where she'll get some more attention and some more work.
All right, guys, I'm doing my voice over here out of the hangar just so I can kind of speak my mind. I'm gonna show you this beautiful shot. My son Apollo is here.
Hi.
And the beautiful mountains here, the wintertime mountains, the new snow on them. Our local airline was landing and I got that beautiful slow motion shot of them landing. So just wanted to show that to you guys. This is a long time coming and a pretty big moment for our family. That's why I wanted my family to be here. Tomorrow marks 6 months since my friend Daniel passed away. So seeing the airplane start up and seeing things come full circle where we're moving forward, not on, as I've said before, but we're moving forward with this project with the airplane. Seeing 2-3 uniform again, roaring, hoping and dreaming of this happening. Now we're not quite there yet. We still have some paperwork stuff to do, but just to have it come alive and have it be running again was a huge, huge blessing. So grateful my family was there. Super thankful for Dave. Dave has been just awesome working on this project. And yeah, I'm just feeling, I have a lot of emotions as you can tell right now. So super grateful, very excited. Still need to remain patient because we still have a lot more to go, or potentially a lot more to go, but just feeling really blessed that we have this beautiful new engine on the airplane. And in many ways it healed my heart. So I wanna say thank you, a big, big, big thank you to you, the audience, for all the interest that you've taken in this project, and especially those that have become our Anglo Attack Angels, or my Alpha Squad, as I call you guys, those that have donated to the engine to get it running, to keep us going, to get 2-3 uniform back in the air. I hope that this was a beautiful moment for you guys too. Now, I still owe you guys some shirts and some of those plaques and stuff. So from parts of the airplane, but we've been working so hard on it. I hope you forgive me for just making sure the airplane runs first. Apollo, I'm kind of wondering how you felt about the engine when it roared up. What did you think?
Good.
Good? Was it louder than you thought it would be?
Yeah.
No, just about as loud. Just a beautiful, beautiful thing. So thanks for being here. Fly safe. And until next time.
Throttle on.